Hey, my name is Baron Batty, and this is my YouTube channel. Basically, this is about a bunch of random stuff pertaining to me as a bus driver that drives in the city of Minneapolis and Minnesota. This video is going to be about people who get on my bus and don't know where they're going. This presents a problem because I drive a route. And another thing is, I'm not a taxi. If you want to get to 2600 West Broadway, apartment 304, I can't do it for you. It's not going to happen. But if you do need to get to the McDonald's that's on West Broadway, right next to the Dollar Tree and the Olympic Cafe, I can help you out. So, the next time you get on the bus, or the next time you go somewhere, do your homework so you can help me out. Don't expect me to get you there without me knowing where you're going, because it causes a lot of confusions. And the whole time, it's a big distraction. You're all in my ear talking and stuff. I'm trying to operate the bus. I got, yo, bro, I don't know where I'm going, but can you please help me out? Like, dude, I can't do it. Just last week, I had a guy that was trying to get to his girlfriend's house. Anyway, the guy gets on the bus, asks me, do I know how to get to such and such, the address? I have no clue. The reason why I have no clue is because we drive straight lines. That's from point A to point B, and a lot of stops in between. But as far as addresses, not going to do it for you. And another thing why it's upsetting is because you get upset. And you deem me incompetent of doing my job because I don't know where you're supposed to be going.
It's like a catch-22 or something. It's crazy. I don't understand that.
How I affect your day because you don't know where you are going. You get upset with me. Call me names. How would you like to be on your job if somebody calls you an idiot or a dummy because you didn't map out the directions? And just to let you know, Metro Transit has a trip to plan on a website. So if you do need to go somewhere, just go there, plan it out. It'll have the directions and get you right where you go. I can get you close, but I can't get you there. It's just a little complicated, and you make other people on the bus mad. And the first thing I'm going to do is get on the intercom and ask people. So you're probably pretty much better off asking your fellow passengers, because not all of us bus drivers know where your destination is. Be easy on us bus drivers. Show us a little compassion. We'll try to do our best to show you a little compassion. Me, I'm a jerk. So if you ask me a question pertaining where you need to be, I'm going to ask you, you don't know where you need to go? You're going to get upset, and I'm still going to go in on you. Because it's not my fault you don't know where the heck you're going. If you don't want to be embarrassed, don't get on my bus. Because if you get mad at me, I'm calling the cops so you can get kicked out. One more thing that is irritating is I'm not a shrink. So a lot of people come on my bus, right, and they want me to solve their problems. I mean, I get people that get on my bus and be like, man, I just got kicked out my girl. She can't stand me. I done did something stupid, and it's over with. What's over with? The relationship? Yeah, bro. It's all messed up. I said, well, what'd you do? I cheated. Well, what you cheat for? This is all happening while I'm driving a bus. So, another thing, just stop doing stupid stuff. Especially when I'm driving. It's real hard to be driving and trying to solve everybody else's earth's problems. So, I mean, last week I had a guy got on my bus, and it's kind of weird how these conversations start. For, you know, I let you in, I'll be like, hey, how you doing? Have a good day. You throw your little change in there, and next thing you know, you're like, why does she hate me? Or, what did I ever do to deserve this? Or, why does God hate me? What did I do to God? I'm like, I don't know. I don't know you from anybody. So you go in on me, and I have to, you know, I'm looking at you like, are you on crack? That's why, you know, don't do drugs. You know, I figured, I'm not saying everybody does drugs when they come in, but dang, for you to be feeling a certain type of way, and the first person you see is the bus driver, and you want to have a heart to heart with them, man, that's you're struggling. You're really struggling. I'm not going to talk to you on my break, so just don't talk to me at all. Because I don't want to deal with it. It's crazy. You get a lot of people with random stuff going on. You're a bus driver. You're a taxi. You're a shrink. And you're a parent. Because most of you people need to be managed just like kids. It's unbelievable the stuff I see on a day-to-day basis. I mean, another thing that really irritates me is people who get on my bus, stand like right behind me. I got a yellow line, so you gotta get back. Remember that. Stand behind the yellow line when you're on the bus. But you stand back there and it's a crowded bus, right? And then it's okay for you like to fart on the bus. Why would you fart on the bus? You know what I'm saying? And it seems like every time somebody does that, it's like right in the front where I am. You can't even go back there and do that. You do it like when you're right behind me. And you know what? It feels like when you fart, it goes in my mouth. I mean, I taste it. It's rude. It makes me want to pull the bus over and just stop. And it's always the silent one. So, you know, no one ever just blows one back. So, you know, everybody looks at you like, ugh, you nasty dude. Or you nasty female. No, it's you blow the silent joints and then you act like nobody happened, you know, no, nothing happened. But we're in a crowded bus, everybody's like, ooh, who did it? Ooh, who did it? Ooh, was it you? Was it you? I'm standing right here. And I'm driving and I smell it. It's all in my throat, all in my mouth. I'm ready to throw up. I'm ready to pull it over to the side and get out, air that bad boy out. So if you ever see a bus driver and he opens up both the windows, that means somebody just blew it back. Somebody just blew it back, literally. And he's just trying to get all that air to circulate up out of that bus. And man, I tell you, man, it's just rude. It's all get out, man. We're in the bus, public place, bus crowded, and you want to do that. Please be nice. Don't blow the bus driver back. Another thing I cannot stand is just blatant ratchetness. For example, the other day I was on my bus and I'm just regular doing my route, and you know I'm on the north side coming from the 5, coming back south towards the Mall of America. And as I pull up to the next stop, I'm here on Plymouth, you know, right next to the Mickey's. Y'all know where that is because y'all peoples be kicking it over there. So you know where it is. On Plymouth here, pull up, Plymouth and Emerson. And I let a family in. I'm going to doing my daily routine and letting people in. They're paying their fare. You always got somebody that do the pat down. You know what I'm saying? They ain't got the money. Can you let me slide? Usually I'm okay with that. But the guy behind him, I just made me stop. And I was like, bruh, are you serious? Now, I don't have a problem with strollers. But this particular stroller, it wasn't even a stroller. It was the strollers you get at the mall, like the Mall of America. You paid a little $5, $6, you know, you pull them out the rack, and then it's a buggy, you know what I'm saying? It's the buggies that you push your kids in, so while you shop. And then after you're done, you return them. But instead, this dude and his girlfriend decides to keep the buggy. And I'm saying, are you serious? This dude is driving around Minneapolis as we speak right now with a red buggy that he stole from the Mall of America. Come on, that is ratchet. I mean, you can go to the Salvation Army, any thrift store, Walmart, Uniques. You don't have to steal from the Mall of America. And when I said, brought it to his attention, I was like, hey, bro, isn't that one of the buggies from the Mall of America? He proudly said with a great smile on his face, yeah, it's all good. I was like, no, it's not. So I just urge people, man, just bring your ratchet level down just a little bit. Have a little shame in your game. and just stop making our people look bad. That just makes us look real bad. Okay, once again, this is Baron Bat T, my YouTube channel. It's about a bunch of random stuff. So maybe next week, if you tune in, I'll have something else for you, some more stories. Subscribe, share to friends if you like. If you have any comments, leave comments down below. You pretty much say what you want to say. I don't care. If you say something stupid, I'm just going to block it. So if you got something bad to say, just keep it moving. You can also offer up words of encouragement. We'll see what happens. All right. I'm out. Deuces.